All right, if you have data that's living inside of Google Sheets, but you want to show it in Canva, we're going to go through how to do that right now. I'm Adam Steinfurth. This is Prolific Oak Tree Channel. Let's get started. All right, on the left, we have our data in Google Sheets. And as you see, you can create charts and sheets, but why you might want to connect it to Canva is you want to get it inside the Canva ecosystem. Maybe use some of their templates, generate some AI art, whatever you want to do inside Canva, we can connect the two. So let's go into Canva and let's start out with, let's just look at their templates and we'll say that we want to connect the chart and bring it into, we'll look at education. This is about trees. So let's try to find science. We'll say science. And you have a lot of choices here. We will pick photosynthesis. Double click on that template. Choose customize a template. And we're not going to open this in the app. So if you leave it in the browser, you'll get the option to connect to Sheets. If you open it in the app, you won't see that. You have to upload the spreadsheet. So we'll say no thanks. And all of these pieces of the flyer, we'll call it, are elements in themselves. So when you click on them, they get highlighted. And so you need to choose where you want your spreadsheet to go. So let's click on this chunk of text. We will delete it, and that makes an empty space to insert our chart. So a chart is considered one of the elements. If you hover over that in the sidebar, you'll get some choices for different charts. Chart choices. Let's find them by clicking in search elements. We'll come down and click on charts. And it will narrow down the options to just the charts. So let's look through these. What we want to show in this case, your data will probably be different, but let's just do a simple pie chart. Go back to the elements. Pie and donut charts. We'll click pie chart. So all these charts come with data that is pre-filled. So it's going to be generic data. You can update it here if there's not very much data, but this video is about connecting it to Google Sheets. So we will come down, we'll select Google Sheets. And the first time you do this, you have to give it permission to be able to read Google Drive. Really, you have to tell Google Drive that it's okay with Canva looking at it. I've already done that, so it can see my files. We're going to check Trees of America in this case. So that's the title of the spreadsheet. You can see that right here. It'll load the spreadsheet and it can see which sheets are in it. We'll stay on sheet one in this case. And then we will take the data from this table. So we'll say E6. And I'm actually going to update this as we go. We're going to say type of tree and we're going to say height. So it needs better labels and you'll see this update live. So I have selected the range. I've included the header row, click update. And now it brings in the right data. Let's move this to where you can see the font a little bit. You'll see it brought in the labels, birch and the 17.5%. Let's shrink this down, put it where we intend to place it in Canva. So we're making a lot of progress, right? You have it in this nice looking template. We'll zoom in and let's just customize it a little bit. We want the font to be a little larger. So we'll increase that. That's looking good. And the last thing that we're going to take advantage of, because remember we wanted to get it into Canva because we think it looks nicer. So let's make it look even better. There's a cool option when you click on the colors for the chart, you'll get an option where it pulls the colors off of the flyer so you can match them. So let's bring this over here so we can see it. We will pick yellow. We'll change this to this other yellow. That's not enough contrast, so we'll pick that color. And these are all colors from the infographic, so it should look pretty nice when we zoom out. We'll pick that one. New. That one. Okay, there we go. We'll zoom out. So you have your chart now inside Canva, and if you need to update it, it's one of the huge advantages of linking it, you can go back to the data sidebar and just click update. All right, so if you are not sure if you want to bring it into Canva, if you'd rather just check out all of the options for making charts inside of Sheets so you don't have to switch between apps, I'll link to a video right now about how to do that. Thanks for watching.